Laboratory sample and sampling procedure. So in this practical, we will perform sampling of our different type of feedstuffs which are commonly used for their chemical composition analysis. We will also discuss a little bit about some other stuff that can also be used for their chemical analysis, or in some time we require their chemical composition. So first of all, what is a sample? Sample is a portion from a large lot. The sample which we take for any analysis or for any purpose, the major objective is to collect a sample that truly represents the total population. Like if we are taking a sample from a population of 1 lakh individuals, the sample which we are taking, that should represent the total population. Otherwise, we could not be able to apply those results, or we cannot apply our findings for the entire population. So that's why we should be very much careful while taking sample of anything. Here we are talking about sampling of feedstuffs, like we want to take sample of green roughages from the field, or we want to take sample of a mixed type of feed in front of animal from its feed manger, or at a feed mill, like there is a supply of different type ingredients. So when they are at the feed mill gate, we have to take a sample so that we can assess their chemical or nutritive composition. Otherwise, we will not be able to adjust the price of the feedstuff which we are going to purchase. So for all that, proper sampling is required. What are the consequences of improper sampling? Like if you take a sample from a trolley and that carry like 100 bags of corn, and you are taking sample from only a few number of bags, and that sample is contaminated with mycotoxins, and you reject the lot. But the rest of the 90 bags, they are of very good quality from where you have not taken the sample. So on the basis of only just a sample from 2 or 3 bags, you cannot reject the lot. The other situation is that you have taken a sample from some sites, and your sample results are very good, or their chemical composition is very good. There is no mycotoxin contamination. But when that lot goes into the formulation side, and your sampling is not correct, in actual, that lot is not good and it is contaminated with mycotoxin. So that will lead to a poor quality product. So this is the importance of proper sampling, so that we would have a clear cut picture about the whole material which we are going to purchase. Otherwise, it might lead to towards a loss in terms of quality of the product, in terms of sale of the product. So sample is a material or the things which we obtain in the form that represent the composition of the substances from where we are sampling. That sample is used for chemical analysis, or it can also be used for a simple laboratory handling. The method used to collect the sample for chemical analysis, that actually affect the nutritive value of the stuff or its overall composition. The handling and preparation is another factor that can also alter the chemical composition. We will discuss in our next practical how improper handling or improper storage might lead to a difference in the chemical composition. Just here, I will give you a simple idea. If you have collected the sample and you are putting in a plastic bag, like it's a green refuges, so that if you are carrying that that sample to a long distance, or that might be during a hot season and you are keeping in a plastic bag. So chances of mold growth are there. So that will also reduce the quality of the sample. First of all, how we can take sample of this powdery material or the granular materials, like if we have a dicalcium phosphate, that is a powdery material, or if it is a limestone, that's a granular material, or even the grains, they are a sort of a granular material. For that, the easiest way is to get a sample. Okay, we should spread the material over a flat surface, and we draw a cross across the sample, like if this is a total sample, and we draw a cross over there. And then we pick up the stuff from two sides and leave the two sides there. These two sides from where we have picked up the material, that will again be spread over there in a uniform layer, then again draw a cross line over there, and then take the two parts and leave the two parts. So finally, if we need 200 gram of samples, so this is a way where we can do sampling of the stuff in a laboratory when there is a small quantity, like there is only 1 kg of the sample or 2 kg of the sample. So that can, from that we can draw a sample like this, drawing a cross over the total material and taking the two diagonal component and returning the two diagonal component, opposite diagonal component back to the stuff. And finally, when we have a 200 gram of the material, so that's a final sample that can be used for proximate analysis. Then there is a sample preparation. We have to grind the sample and transfer this to a sampling jar. So quartering of the sample we have discussed. So this is when we are doing the stuff within the lab. We are taking sample or we are getting a representative sample from a small lot, and that practice can be done in a lab. But when there is a large type of material, like if we are dealing with a truck that contain a lot of stuff, or we are dealing with the material in the field that is a 2 acre or 3 acre field, and we want to take a grass sample or fodder sample from there, then you can have to go in a different way, or you can get the sample in a little different way. So for grassland material, if it is a large field and we want to collect sample from that large field, the one way is that we should move to the different areas or different location of the field and cut the sample 3 or 4 inches above the ground and take the whole plant out. And then taking multiple samples from the field at different random locations. So at least 10 to 15 locations, they should be taken into consideration for the sampling. And that should be then made available outside of the field. And we chop the material over there. And after mixing, we can perform the same methodology of taking the representative sample as we did for the granular material or powdery material in the laboratory. Here I will explain over here in a little more detail. Okay, if sampling the aerial part of the plant in the field, like if there is a browsing material, or we are only concerned with the top portion of the plant, then at least 10 locations at random, and then take a sample from that area. Then how we can decide where from where we should get the sample? For that, there is we can use a quadrant that is made up of a steel, or it may be made up of a wood. So it is 1 meter square. So its diameter is about 1 meter square. Or then we throw this quadrant in the field at different locations 10 or 15 locations for getting the sample. The material within the quadrant is then clipped. Now the question arises, because if it is made up of steel, steel and its diameter is 1, then it could be difficult to throw the stuff through that quadrant. So for that, the easiest way is to use a stone and throw it in the field, and where that stone falls, you can place the quadrant and then clip the aerial part of the plant. So then save the sample in a plastic bag. So that depend upon, I have mentioned, can depend upon the season, but better is to take the stuff in a paper bag. But for moisture content, and if you are taking the material or keeping the material for a long time, then moisture loss will occur in a paper bag. So our concern is to know about the moisture content, then we have to put in the plastic bag, and we should immediately transfer it to the lab for further analysis. So if the plant is large in size, then it may be necessary to take sample to the laboratory and run it through a forage cutter to obtain a representative sample. This practice can be done even on the farm or in the field where forage cutter is available. If it is not available, then take that large plant in the laboratory. And the moisture of the sample is removed by drying, grind and dried the material by using a hammer wheel. So adopt the same procedure as for grain or poultry material, so finally, so that we can have a 200 gram of the sample. So take a sample at a random for what is being fed to the animal. The sample should be about 3 to 4 kg, and further processing is same as for the grassland material. This is for hay, silage and green forage sample. So in this case, you can pluck the topmost portion, about top 1/3 of the plant can be used, because that material is being taken up by the animals, grazing animals. So that is the portion which is being used for analysis purpose, because the animals, they are only grazing the topmost or leafy part of the plant. Grain and for grain and meal mixtures, grains, they are usually available, or they are supplied either as such in a truck or trolley, or they are in a bag form. So use a slotted tube or rod with pointed end. This is a sort of grain probes. So these are three different type of probes. The first two, the top two, this one and this one, they can be used for grain purpose, and this one can be used for the material like meals. So take at least 1 kg of sample. How you can take a sample? Remove the sample from 3 or 4 different sites using a bag sampler. So you can take sample by using these grain probes or bag samplers. Here are the bag samplers that can be placed into the bag, and you can take the sample. So 3 to 4 samples are from each bag from its different sites. Then subsampling can be done. If there is a lot of 1 to 10 bags, then take sample from all bags. It is if it is a lot of more than 10, then at least 10 bags at randomly. For bulk feed, draw at least 20 cores from different sites. Like if it is on a trolley, a truck, there is no bag material, that is just simply bag placed on the trolley. So you can at least go for 20 different sites, cold sites, to get the samples. And then take that sample into the laboratory and then thoroughly mix it. So after mixing, then you can draw the representative sample by making crossover over the material and quartering the whole material you have taken, and then after quartering you can take the sample as you did for the grassland material or for powdery material. So this is how you can go for when you are taking a there is a bulk carrier of grain. I have mentioned about trolley or truck. So you can go in this way, like zigzag, and you can take the sample on the top layer, on the bottom, then in the middle of the same place. So at least multiple samples can be taken from this side. the top, center, and then at the bottom. If we are going to analyze meat and meat products, so in that case, we also need sample. So separate the meat from the bone and skin, the meat or meat mixture, it should be run through a meat chopper or mincer. So after mincing, thoroughly mix the material, and then you can go for quartering of the sample and take the sample and place it in a jar and store at a low temperature. Semi-solid mixed liquid, liquid solid type material. So like cheese and chocolate, they should be coarsely grated. So after grating, material should be thoroughly mixed, and then we can take the sample by quartering the stuff. Semi-viscous material, like if we are talking about a milk sample, we have a pudding material, and then there is a liquid containing solids, fruits, squash. So they should be thoroughly blended on a high speed blender, or they should be mixed with the rod. If there is no need of blending, then we can take the sample from different locations of the container. Feces and urine samples, they are required for their analysis when we are doing digestibility trial to know about the digestibility of the feedstuff. In that case, we need fecal and urine sample. So we need a plastic container to collect the fecal and urine, at least for the urine. They contain some of the gaseous stuff, and they also contain the microorganism, particularly in case of feces, that cause the fermentation. So immediately after taking the fecal and urine sample, we have to place it at a low temperature. Otherwise, the fermentation will occur, or the in case of urine, the loss of ammonia might occur. So to avoid these losses, we have to place it in a container, and then that should be placed in at a low temperature. And 50 ml wing bottle to prevent loss of the moisture, particularly in case of fecal material. And then I would take the sample to the laboratory for proper labeling storage at low temperature. We can also use some preservatives to avoid fermentation of the stuff, but to the immediate step is to take the sample in a either a stainless steel container or plastic bottles, and then airtight it and place them at a low temperature. So after that, you can, if you would like to draw sample for your analysis from the large sample, then thoroughly mix the stuff by using a rod, and then take at least 50 ml of the urine sample for further analysis. Similarly, for fecal material, if you are getting from an animal, so that animal is defecating like the 10 kg of the fecal material, so you have to take some large sample from that fecal material after thoroughly mixing by using the rod. And then after collection, you can go for placing it in the cool place or at a low temperature. Or if you want to reduce the sample, you want to take only the sample which you are going to analyze only, then after taking that large sample, then do the quartering, or you can take the sample at different locations of the container according to your need. So it should be like in case of feedstuff, we need only 200 gram of sample, but in case of feces material or green material, moisture contents, they are high. So at least we have to go for at least 300 or 400 gram of sample, so that at the end in a dry form, we can have at least 100 gram of the sample for analysis purpose. So this is all about this sampling.